Hey folks, this is Riker, bringing you a Heroes of the Storm beginner guide to an absolutely critical concept when it comes to winning games. And this is the concept of laning. We're going to go over what it is and why it's so crucial towards paving the road to victory. But first, let me ask you a philosophical question. If an enemy minion dies in a lane and no one on your team is around to see it, does it give XP? The answer is no. Getting XP from enemy minions is so easy that it's silly not to do it. You don't even have to attack the minions. You just have to be in the general area when they die. Now, the exact range isn't known precisely, but it's roughly half a screen away, or about the sight radius of your hero. In Heroes, laning means ensuring that you have someone in lane to get XP when enemy minions die. And the first phase of the game is the laning phase. This is the early game, and it ends when your team reaches level 10. You see, before level 10, one of the major objectives of the game is to get to level 10 before your enemy. And the reason you want to do that is because at 10 you get your ultimates. This gives you a tremendous advantage over the enemy team, and basically ensures that your team will win any team fight. When you get to 10 before the enemy team, you have a huge lead, and you want to make sure that you don't squander that lead. So you want to do what you can to force a team fight. Generally, this means that the enemy team can't contest an objective, like a tribute, or it gives them a difficult decision to make if you decide to push a fort. Do they risk trying to defend it and getting their whole team killed? Or do they just forfeit that fort to you? Suffice it to say, getting to 10 first is a big deal. And the only way that you can beat your enemy to level 10 is by getting more XP than them. Now, there are ways to do that proactively through tactics called zoning, which basically means forcing the enemy to retreat so that they can't get XP. But the most basic thing is just to ensure that your team isn't missing out on any XP anywhere. In your typical game, you have 5 heroes on your team and 3 lanes on the map. That means you have enough people on your team to keep one person in lane at all times, with 2 people free to go about roaming, ganking, capturing mercenary camps, or doing whatever else they want to do. But if you leave a lane empty and enemy minions are dying in that lane, your team is forfeiting XP. And unless the enemy team is also forfeiting XP in a lane, your team will fall behind. Now again, this is applicable to the early game, before you hit level 10. Once you get higher in level, player kills start to give a lot more XP. But a mistake people often make in the early game is to overestimate the impact of kills. One lane's worth of enemy minions gives you more XP than killing one enemy player. And that applies up until around level 4, at which point they're equal. But still, when you're going after an enemy kill, you're taking a risk. So unless you're guaranteed that kill, and you're guaranteed to get it in a timely manner, it's often not worth chasing after kills. Or rather, it's often not worth forfeiting a lane in order to chase a kill. Remember, we have 2 people free to roam and gank, and those guys should be trying to go for the kill and the zone as much as possible. Just not at the expense of laning. The only time it's acceptable to abandon a lane before level 10 is for map objectives, not for mercenary camps, and especially not for watchtowers. There's this obsession with fighting over watchtowers, especially the central ones like on Blackheart's Bay, for the first 50 seconds of the game. Yes, it's fun to do, and I guess that's fine if you just want to have a good time, but if you have a good time by winning, that's not an optimum strategy. Yeah, you might get some early kills, but you have an equal chance to die. If you are just laning, playing carefully, playing defensively, no one should be dying. It doesn't matter if you're the only person in your lane, and there are 3 enemies in that lane. Your job is just to stay alive and get XP. Even if they push you down to your towers, get behind your wall, stay alive. Take pot shots if you can, but just stay alive. Let your towers do their work, kill the enemy minions, and be there to collect the XP. Don't freak out. Don't abandon the lane. If you're one person in your lane, and the enemy team has 3 people in your lane, that means your team has an advantage somewhere else on the map. Don't freak out, just soak, get the XP. If you're wondering why your team is falling behind in the early game, I can guarantee you, it's either because your team has left a lane empty for some period of time, or because your team is feeding the enemy kills. And sometimes both of these happen at the same time. That also means that if someone on your team dies and he was the only person in that lane, and you're currently in a lane with another person, you should rotate down there and cover that lane until your teammate respawns and comes back. Yeah, maybe he made a mistake by overextending, but if you see an empty lane and you decide to leave it empty, you're not helping your team catch up. Now, there are exceptions to this rule for more advanced players. If you're doing some really coordinated shenanigans, then maybe you want to opt for that. Or if you see that the enemy team has left a lane empty, then you know that you can afford to also leave a lane empty and still be on par with them. But as a rule of thumb for beginners, until your team hits level 10, never leave a lane empty, except for objectives. And once you hit 10, group up with your team. Follow this super simple advice, and your win rate is gonna start going up, because you'd be surprised by how often people leave lanes empty. So if you're that person on your team ensuring that your team doesn't make that mistake, well, you're just that much more likely to win. That wraps up this guide. Thanks for watching. Check out these other videos and stay tuned for more Heroes of the Storm content. If you enjoyed this video, share it with friends, leave a comment, hit like, and subscribe to join Riker's Raiders.